as we were pricing markets, we'd have a trader on the desk who was adjusting spreads to try, you know, capture more flow, make sure the client experience is the best it could be, you know, keep it as tight as possible, but, you know, within the constraints of the market. And that was a very time consuming job. They had to constantly be monitoring, constantly be doing this. But at ING, we've always, you know, tried to be innovative and, you know, be one step ahead of the market. And in this, we were looking, how can we do this better? What sort of methods can we use? And with this, we looked at an AI model. So over the last few months, we started to develop this model. And what we found was this model could really just outperform the human. It was better at predicting the market, adjusting the spreads. And, you know, maybe if you remember the AlphaGo model, where a few years ago now, it was the experts were astounded when it found sort of strategies that the humans had never found. And we found this with this model. It was, you know, adjusting spreads in ways we'd have never done as humans.
That's interesting. You did it, though, by hiring a human machine programmer. Talk to us about his work, because the creating that AI model and how you program it is kind of the secret to the success, isn't it?
Yeah, of course. In AI, I mean, it is still human driven. Uh-huh. AI is not creating AI, it's not machines creating machines. So again, in this case, we were thinking, where's the market going to go? How do we hire? And we've seen this over the last 20 years in effect, you know, as the market's changed from very traditional voice traders. And, you know, slowly at the start, we saw quant start to get onto the desk. We saw sort of very good developers start to drift onto FX desks. And then over the last few years, we've really seen it accelerate. You know, the sort of shift in skill set has gone from the traditional voice trade to sort of quants and developers. And now we thought, well, okay, what's the sort of next evolution in that step? And that's where we thought AI, that's the next thing. So we went to the market, we hired AI specialist, and his first, well, you know, you always just come in and go, there you go, make things better. So we sort of gave him a task. It wasn't, you know, we didn't tell him what to do. We sort of gave him free rein and said, you know, come up with a new great idea, and that's what he did.
So Simon, it's proving effective when it comes to FX. Do you oversee a broader asset mix than FX? So are you looking to deploy this with other asset classes, fixed income? Is that in your sights, equities? How are you thinking about expanding the scope of this?
Yeah, I think, I mean, that's a really good question. So over the last few years, sort of ING's gone through this amazing sort of digitization project. And what we found is, like, each asset class was very siloed. So we got to the end of that and we started to look, you know, how do we take this the next step? So sort of the next, again, to use the word evolution of the sort of digitization, we've said, okay, how do we then take the best in class from each asset class, you know, the best tech, the best ideas, the best sort of algos, can we use those across asset? And so we created this idea of a cross asset group. And this is it literally just happened a few weeks ago. And this is a perfect example of where we can take this model, which has been trained on FX, is very specific to FX, but the underlying idea is not FX specific, and we can move it to different assets. So you mentioned FI. I think credit will be one of the first ones we'll look at doing. You know, the sort of price construction, how we create a price is very similar there. So, you know, it's not quite lift and shift, but it's you know, we've
does
got
that happen
idea.
This year, or is it a longer time?
I think this year we'll start it. The training may maybe take a little, but certainly early next year we'll get this working in credit.